Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come on, fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, we'll float down to Peru.
Hey, can I get a whiskey?
In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Fly with me, we'll take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide.
Hey, look, it's my dad.
I get you up there.
Hey, Daddy-o, I didn't know you could sing. Oh, that's right, you can't.
You might hear angels cheer, cause we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. You just say those words, we'll whip those birds down to Acapulco Bay. It is perfect for a flying honeymoon, oh babe. Come fly with me, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away.
Let's hear it for Shorty. Come on, everybody. Isn't that the best impersonation of old Blue Eyes you ever seen? Kind of like a mini-me version of the chairman. Hey, now this is what I call music. Yeah, sing it, dude.
Woo!
Right on.
Union when the strike was down on his luck. She dreams of running away. She cries in the night. Tommy whispers, baby, it's okay. Someday you gotta hold on to what we got. It doesn't make a difference if we make it or not.
I need a cab at Cafeteries Bar, Shoreline Drive, and,
28th.
28th. Thanks.
You're welcome.
You got a nice voice.
Oh, you heard all that.
Yeah. I'm sorry about that. He's usually not such a humongous jerk. He got some bad news today.
Whatever it is, I hope it's terminal. Yeah, it's all right. No harm done.
What was the song that you were singing?
Come Fly With Me. Sammy Kahn and Jimmy Van Heusen wrote it specifically for Frank. They recorded in true stereo. It was released in 58 in mono only, a standard practice by Capitol Records at the time. The differences between the mono recording and the stereo recording are quite striking. Some hold the mono recording as having a depth and warmth, most especially in some of the string and brass sections, which is lacking in the stereo remix. But of course, I can't do the song justice in a joint like this. No one understands great songwriting anymore. Except you, maybe. Can I buy you a drink, Dollface?
You're funny.
Funny's good, right?
Funny's good.
So is that a yes?
I gotta work in the morning.
Call in sick?
Maybe some other time.
Where are you from?
Around.
Around.
I meant what I said about your voice.
Thanks. I like yours too. Accents are kind of sexy.
What accent?
Hey! Flash your lights so we can see what else you got for Christmas!
I gotta go.
Yeah, sure, kid. I'll see you around, maybe.
Kid? Really?
Hey, what's your name?
with your subscription, you'll receive offers for awesome deals, like the chance to win free parking or gift cards to cool stores. Such as...
Are you sure?
Can you hold on for just 1 minute?
Really?
Thank you.
But it's a really good deal. Where else can you get 2 dozen oysters for the price of one? Mister?
She wants to know which stores.
Which stores what?
We have gift cards for.
How should I know? No one's ever won one.
Oh, crap, I lost her. Never mind.
That was pathetic. You call yourself salesman, you're not salesman. A 6-year-old could have closed that deal. The first rule of salesmanship is what? Hello, I can't hear you.
The first rule.
Cleto.
Know your product?
That's right, Cleto. Know your product. And if you don't know your product, you what?
You make stuff up.
You make stuff up? Now my advice to you boys is start selling or start looking for another job. You got it? Yeah. Where are they?
Oh, should be here any minute.
How do I feel about lateness, Arn?
You hate it worse than hemorrhoids?
Worse than hemorrhoids.
Morning, Donna Delightful. Morning, boys.
Morning, Jer.
Morning, Jer.
Cutting it a little close, aren't you?
Well, like the chairman says. Hello, Mrs. Pratesh. It's Jerry. How are you this fine morning? Has anyone ever told you that you have a great voice? Well, you do. You're a regular Miss Peggy Lee. Have you had a chance to think any more about my offer? You'll take it. That's great. I'll send the final details and that's that. Thank you, Mrs. Pratesh. You have a good one. It's all in the timing.
I know, I'm late. I'm so sorry. Why do they call it the better way? Why? It's not. I left in plenty of time, okay? I get on the streetcar, it sure turns on me.
It happens too much.
Way too much.
So now I'm like trying to call and tell you what happened and my phone totally messes up. I so hate you. And then I see some kid on a bike. You know, those peg things for popping wheelies?
Those things are dangerous.
A friend of mine can't have kids because of those things.
So I weighed him down and I explained to him what happened and he's so sweet. So he lets me hop on. And he's pedaling as fast as he can, but he's only like 12 or something, so he's got these little toothpick legs and he can't go very fast. And then he gets a call from his mom saying he has to come home right now. So he drops me off. I ran the rest of the way. And then my knee really hurts and I'm terrified I'm gonna need an operation or something. Does arthroscopy surgery hurt?
You're fired. Can I see you in my office for a second?
She didn't mean it.
You think so?
Yes, he did.
Don't worry, I've got this.
Jerry.
Cheer up.
Yeah, it's not the end of the world, right?
Cleto's right. I mean, who needs this crappy old job anyway, huh?
I do. I owe 3 months' rent. I need groceries. I need hot water. I can't take another sponge bath at the 7-Eleven. And no, Mother, I am not, repeat, not moving back home! Did I say that out loud? Oh my God, I'm so off the reservation right now.
Well, maybe if you put your head between your knees, it'll help.
Yeah, and take deep breaths.
Yeah.
Just, come on, breathe it all out.
They are breathing down my neck, Jerry.
Who is?
Who do you think, head office? My numbers are down.
Oh, what do they expect? People don't buy useless crap?
Non-essential.
Non-essential crap when the economy's in the dumper.
Yeah, well, we better figure out a way to sell that useless crap or else we're all gonna be in the dumper. I'd like to see them make the numbers with the three stooges out there.
Oh, come on, they're not that bad.
you're gonna go on a little vacation, you're gonna find another job, it's gonna be a better job, you're gonna be doing awesome job.
I waited up for you. Didn't you get my text?
My phone died on me.
Liar. Will I see you tonight?
I'll try.
Try hard. I have a new peekaboo nighty that needs a test drive.
Don't fire Layla.
Will I see you tonight?
Yeah, sure, Dollface.
I love it when you call me that. Layla, you're not fired.
Really?
You heard me. Now the rest of you get back on those phones and sell that useless crap as if your life depended on it, which they do.
Theater lover boy. Oh, make sure to use the service elevator this time. I can't have the neighbors reporting back to hubby dearest when he gets back, now can I? Off you go.
I've got a crush on you, sweetie pie. All the day and night time, hear me sigh. I never had the least notion that I could fall with so much emotion.
Oh, wait, no!
You little prick. Just who do you think you are?
Owen, stop it. Leave him alone.
Hey, listen, pal.
I'm not your pal, you pathetic wannabe.
Take it easy. You're wrinkling the material, okay?
You're a joke. You're a sad, ridiculous little
Owen,
joke.
It wasn't him. It was me.
Didn't Sinatra ever teach you not to hustle another guy's girl?
I'm not your girl.
Seems like you're misinformed, pal.
Show you misinformed.
Jerry?
Oh, God.
Don't worry. I got this.
Yeah! Yeah!
Hey, asshole!
Ah! Ah! God! Ah! Ah! God! I! No! Ah! I can't see! Ah!
Go, 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 go!
Hey, assholes!
Oh, my eyes! My eyes!
I'll show you misinformed.
Pow! Are you all right?
I think so.
Let me just see.
Hey, Jerry. I gotta get going. Don't want to be late for work, right, boys?
It's not that late.
Yeah, it's not a good idea to be late.
Ever. We should go.
Nice meeting you, Martina.
Real nice.
Yeah. Nice meeting you guys, too.
I'll see you crazy kids in the morning.
Those are the Pleiades. And see that? That's the Archer.
How come you know so much about stars?
When I was little, if I couldn't go to sleep, my grandpa would let me look through his telescope at the stars. He lived with us after my Nana died. My turn to ask a question?
Ask away.
How come you know so much about Sinatra?
It's easy. It's all I have left of my dad. When I was a kid, and I felt sad because I didn't have a dad like all the other kids, I put on Sinatra. And pretty soon I couldn't listen to anything else.
Felt the same way about Spice Girls.
I wonder if he left them behind on purpose.
Why?
Well, maybe it was his way of teaching me about life. They say if it's worth knowing, Sinatra's got a song about it.
Can I ask you another question?
Sure.
Promise not to get mad.
I'm all ears, kid.
Have you ever thought about singing as yourself?
What do you mean?
Well, you know, not imitating anyone else.
I never really thought of it.
Maybe you should.
Maybe I will. My turn?
Okay.
Where are you from, really?
My mom and I moved here from Slovakia after my dad died.
So why not just admit it?
I think I just did.
Maybe it's time we both stop pretending?
Sounds good. Quick,
Shooting star, make a wish. Be someplace?
For once, I'm right where I need to be. When you wish upon a star, doesn't matter who you are. When you wish upon a star, they all come true. If your heart is in your dreams, life is safe.